Hello guys, today we'll work with this Apple device, iPhone 11 Pro, that heats up after turning on and shortly after it shuts down. It's that type of issue that we can find every day. With the help of Leonardo, in today's video, we'll try to solve this iPhone 11 Pro. Whether you are a technician or not, this is one of our best videos on our YouTube channel. So stay close, we won't disappoint you. To can get to the motherboard, we need to remove the two screws from the bottom part to hit the screen and then to use a plastic picky tar to cut the adhesive. So it won't take long with the disassembly process. Let's use fast camera to save time. Time is gold and is one of the most valuable resources we have.
Let's go. Yeah, I'm like an addict, do I gotta have it. I ain't even playing, got a really bad habit. If it moves, gotta grab it, fuse like a magnet. Lose, won't have it till I'm doomed in a casket.
Little by little, on our YouTube channel, you'll see new tools. We are changing our way to work and understand the motherboard repairs. For those of you who are just starting with repairs, our YouTube channel is a fantastic resource of free content. Knowing that the device heats up a lot, we'll set the power laboratory supply to 0.5 amperes and we analyze the consumption. Setting the power laboratory supply to 3 amperes has the same result. Suddenly high consumption and then the device shut down. I forgot to record this step, but lately you'll see the details. Before separating the two motherboards, we must remove these protectors. To do it right, we apply a little isopropyl alcohol. And that's facts. Only I can make a change. Slowly take a step today. Here we can notice a small blow. Remember that before taking any decision, we need to inspect the motherboard very well. We are going to remove this shield to check if everything is fine. To remove this metal sheet, we use 400 Celsius degrees and 80% of air. Here's a video to understand the correct way to remove these metal shields. Did you notice how this crystal oscillator blew up? If it's not soldered properly, this can happen. We've inspected the area, we solder it using a little bit of solder paste and everything is fine. But the fault of this device is not here. We are going to proceed to separate the two motherboards. So for this process, we'll use this tool. In our video description, you'll find the purchase link for this tool and some others. Check it. Here I leave you a small tip. Never try to apply force when you separate the two motherboards. I know very well the separation temperature for this tool, but I try to do it at a lower temperature so you can understand it logically. The temperature displayed on the screen doesn't matter, only the technique matters. Gently try to remove the motherboard. If the board resists, raise the temperature by 10 degrees. If the top part of the motherboard resists, you need to increase the temperature by another 10 degrees. Remember that the motherboard won't be affected at all because the solder lid melts before the solder lid of the components. You can even use flux to help. we use the tip of the scalpel and we remove the motherboard. Then we turn off the tool. To cool down the motherboard, I use a USB computer ventilator. In the description of this video, I leave you the purchase link. I won't go into details now, but after soldering any integrated circuit or joining or separating any motherboard, you must use the ventilator. In this way, we quickly lower the temperature and avoid damaging other components with resin around them. Let's inspect the solder bolts that joins the two motherboards. As you can see, everything is perfect. Honestly, this step is like a child's play, and with a good technique, you can't fail. Always use common sense and don't try to separate the two motherboards if the solder hasn't become liquid. Remember that this device has an overheating issue. During our visual inspection, we found out that the solder balls are burned. In this case, the voltages and data will not pass correctly from one motherboard to another. As a protective measure, the iPhone shuts down. This is the explanation and the cause of this device failure. We continue our visual inspection, searching for other faults. For technicians, these devices are a gold mine because in 5 years you can still charge around €100 or $100 for each repair. We are talking about high-end iPhone devices that maintain their value in the market over the years. To solve this device issue, we need to scrape the burnt pads. In this way, we properly reconnect the two motherboards again. This device has been on the market for almost 3 years. Failing after 3 years is normal, so we'll extend its useful life for another 3 or even 4 years. The trick is here. Use a good flux to reactivate the original solder lid. In this way, we risk the motherboard less and we won't lose the thermal paste, which is essential for heat dissipation. Now, to join the two motherboards, I like to use this tool. In the video description, I leave you the purchase link. You need to select the joining temperature at 220 Celsius degrees, which is the same temperature for the separation process. After reaching 220 Celsius degrees, we turn off the tool. Here's a small tip: cool the motherboard using a ventilator. In this way, we'll protect the motherboard much better. Over the years, we have analyzed our repairs and always we try to improve the quality of our service. Occasionally, due to the flux, the motherboard may stick to the mold. If it resists, apply a little isopropyl alcohol. We won't take long with the assembly process. Let's use fast camera. I don't ever slow up, no I don't take sh**. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up. I don't ever slow up, no I don't take sh**. I got no love for the fakeness. It seems that the device battery has run out, which is normal for this issue. No I don't take sh**. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this. That's it, we now have an image on the screen and a good 2 amperes charge on the Power Z tool. In this way, we solved the issue of this iPhone 11 Pro. Guys, here's Leonardo, this was today's video, hope you like it and see you in the next one. Bye bye!
don't know if that can erase all the past and the pettiness, a reflection of the emptiness. Hilarious, you think you're worth my time, you're delirious. Mysterious, because you hide behind a fake exterior. Inferior, you know I'll always be a bit superior. Get off of me, this ain't no humble brag. I want you to hear words, you can say them back. I want you to feel free from the chains that last.